जय जय राधारमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधारमण हरि गोविंद जय जय ओम नमो भगवते पुराण पुरुषोत्तमाय ओम जयति पराशर सूनु सत्यवती हृदय नंदनो व्यास यस्यास्य कमलगंतम वाग्मे ममतम जगत्प्रेवती विश्वसर्ग विसर्गादि नवलक्षण लक्षतम श्रीकृष्णाक्षं परम धाम जगद्धाम नमामि तत् हृदयस्य प्रेरणया प्रवर्तितोऽहं पराकृपोऽपि तस्य हरे पदकमलं वंदे श्रीचैतन्यदेवस्य वंदेहं श्रीगुरो श्रीपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं साधन रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादां सागरलता श्रीविशाखान्विताश्च अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुर्वे नमः दिव्यभण्डारण्यकल्पद्रुमाघ श्रीमद्रत्नागाररत्नसिंहासनस्थौ श्रीमद्राधाश्रीगोविन्ददेवौ प्रेष्ठालीभिः सेव्यमानौ स्मरामि नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये वाञ्छाकल्पतोभ्यश्च कृपासुतुभ्यैव च पत्तानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः हे श्रीसनातनप्रभो करुणाम्बुराशे हे रूप दुर्गत जनैक दयावलोको हे भट्टियुग्म सुमते रघुनाथदास श्रीजीव मे गुरुमंदमते नयांतरा बोल वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। परम मंगल श्री श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण वेरी वेरी ऑस्पिशियस श्री श्री श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण द किंग ऑफ ऑल स्कल्पचर्स वोकल इंकार्नेशन ऑफ श्री कृष्णचंद्र श्री द्वादश स्कंध इन द्वादश स्कंध श्री सूति जी वाज डिस्क्राइबिंग दैट श्री मार्कंडेय मुनि हैज विटनेस्ड द डिसॉल्वेशन ही आस्क्ड द बेनिडिक्शन that I want to see the Maya and Shri Narayan Bhagwan showed him the Maya. Maya has two faces, one face is Jiva Maya and other is Guna Maya. By Guna Maya, all creation, existence and the destruction is done. That is Guna Maya. And by Jiva Maya, while Maya comes in the connection of, in the contact of a Jiva, then it conceals the, she conceals the Swarup of a Jiva. Satchitanand, and Jeev is thinking the illusion. He is founding the illusion that I am body. So that is the difference between Jiva Maya and Guna Maya. Sri Markandeya Muni has seen the Srishti, Sthiti and Samhar. And once he, while he was just floating in the dissolution ocean, Pralaya Samudra. There he saw, he think that where this earth is, whole universe is based. And at that time, the bhakti that is performed by Sri Markandeya Muni previously, due to that, Sri Markandeya Muni saw Sri Balmukam. There was a island, and in island there was a Bhatta Vriksha, and in buttocks on a leaf or on the bowl of leaves. Shri Bhagavan was sleeping there, and he was very beautiful and attractive, and he was sucking his toe with his, catching his feet with his hand and giving it into his mouth, and he was sucking it. And Markandeya Muni just want to, while he approached to Shri Bhagavan, he was thinking that where this, who is the creator of this whole universe? So Shri Yogamaya showed that Shri Bhagavan is the creator of the whole universe, and he is the Abhinnam Nimitto Vadan Karan, he is the raw material as the creator also of this whole universe. Then one question was also there, that where this whole universe is based. And as Shri Markandeya Muni moved to Shri Bhagavatam, the Bhagavatam, that child has taken the inhale, and as soon as he take the breath inward, Shri Markandeya Muni went into the his valley, and there he seen that this whole universe is based on Shri Bhagavatam. There he seen Himalaya, Pushpavaha Nadi, his ashram own and his colleagues were also there. And he was seeing everything, that everything is in the valley of Shri Bhagavatam. And as he tried to talk to his colleagues, the child has again take the breath, and he leave the breath, and by that Markandeya Muni again came into the dissolution ocean, that Pralaya Samudra. And there Markandeya Muni in this way came to know that a person can get rid from all these ties of Maya if he has taken the shelter of Shri Bhagavatam. So in this way, this is not only a story, it also shows that the doctrines, that where the whole universe is based, who is the creator of whole universe, which is the raw material of whole universe, and how a person will get relief from his illusion and his ignorance that I am body. If he has taken the shelter of Shri Bhagavatam, then he can get rid of all these ties. And Markandeya Muni in this way was very, very much formed by this doctrine, what he has seen, that Shri Bhagavatam is the upasya, he is worth worship, and jeev is worshipable, neither the whole universe is worshipable, because universe of prakriti is jar, and jeev is very much limited. The omni powerful, omnipresent, omni powerful thing is Shri Krishna, and you should serve Shri Krishna. This was the conclusion of the story. And Markandeya Muni, getting this perception, at last he was he concentrated in the meditation of Shri Krishna, and in transposition he was seeing Shri Krishna. Now the further story is being described by Shri Sudhiji. Shri Sudhiji is saying व्यस्प्रपन्नोऽप्यन्धमूलते प्रपन्नाभयदं हरे जन्माया बुधा मुह्यन्ति ज्ञान काशया. वंस श्री भगवान रुद्र विद उमा एंड हिज ऑल अंतरास वॉज रोमिंग एंड पासिंग अवे बाय दैट वे एंड देयर ही सॉ श्री मार्कंडेय मुनि. श्री पार्वती आस्क्ड दैट टू श्री शिव जी, सर यू आर दिस ब्राह्मण इज डूइंग austerity for a long time and you always gives the opulences, vaibhav or siddhi, the perfection. So give some perfection to this boy also, this man also, Markandeya Muni. And Shivji was saying, no, Parvati, she does not want anything. So Markandeya Muni was thinking and always a prapannosmi angamulante. We are starting 10th chapter. So Markandeya Muni was, as Markandeya Muni has witnessed the dissolution, Srishti Pada Samhar, so now he is surrendering himself to the lotus feet of Sri Balmukha. And as he has witnessed Balmukundu also, so he is surrendering himself to Balmukundu. So prapannosmi, and at last in conclusion he is deciding and he is performing that prapannosmi angam mulante, O Shri Krishna, I surrender to your lotus feet. Prapanna abhayadam hare, O Hari, you are giving the protection from all fears. So prapanna, who had taken your shelter, he will get free from all difficulties, from all fears. Janmaya prabhu yan kashaya, even the intelligent persons are bewildered by and they are confused by your maya. So jan maya vibhudha, vibhudha means who are the scholars, who are very much intelligent persons, they persons are also being jan maya vibhudhanti, they are also confused by your maya. Gyan kashaya, because this maya is always transforming, even then it seems that it is everlasting. And Gyan Kashya means it is manifesting like Gyan, but it is not Gyan, it is Agyan, and it is not permanent, it is always transforming. So in this way, Vibhudha Muhyanti Gyan Kashya, the other persons, even scholar, are confused by your maya. So in this way, Markandeya Muni has surrendered Shri Krishna fully. Sudha Goswami is saying ke tamem nirvatatmanam prishir div parshaparetam. So once, while Shri Shivji, Shri Rudra Bhagwan Uma, riding on the bull, he is going on Nandi, Rudyanya Bhagwan Rudra Dadasya Swagani Vrtaha. He saw Shri Markandeya Muni doing meditation in his ashram, in his place. Adhomam Tamriti Rishim Bhiksha Grisham Sambhashava. Shri Parvati requested and persist Shri Shivji that Pashyamam Bhagwan Vipram. Sir, just see this Vipra, this Brahman, for a long time he is doing meditation and he is doing here the austerity, the tap. So Nirvatatmen Driyashayam, he has controlled his mind he has controlled his senses and he has controlled his intellect also. So Nirvana Atma, Indri and Ashay. Ashay means mind, Indri means senses, and Atma, that means he is intelligent. He has controlled all things. Buddhi, Man, Indri. Nirvatod Jashabratam Vata Pai Vandavam. And he is now sitting very much quiet and calm, very much in full tranquility. He is sitting here and he is meditating. So he seems to be an ocean where the storm is finished and the ocean is became very calm, and it is very gambhir, it is very profound, and there is no struggling of no quarreling of the fishes. So he is also in resembles like a ocean, a calm and quiet ocean, shant. So Nirvata Uda Jashabratam, where the Jashabrat, that means crocodiles and the fishes, are concealed and they are hidden in the deep water. They are hidden in the deep water. Bhatta Pai, the storm is finished, over. Jathanavam, so he is seeing just like a ocean. Kurvasya Tapsa Sakha, Saksha, and he is doing his austerity, tap, and Sakshat San Siddhim Siddhido Bhavan. You are the Siddhidoham Siddhita. You are the giver of all Siddhi and perfections. So just Sakshat San Siddhim. Please also give some Siddhi, some perfection and some opulences to this Rishi also. So he prayed that Shri Parvati ji prayed to Shri Shiva that you give some Siddhi to Shri Markandeya. And then Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Shri Rudra Bhagavan was answering to Parvati ke naive ichhanti ashishak vapi. O Parvati, she is not requiring any ashish, any desire, because his whole desires are completed and he has left all desires. Not completed, but he has left all desires. He is not requiring anything more. So naiva ichhati ashishak kvapi. Any desire ever, he is not requiring anything. Brahmarshi moksha mapyata. This Brahmarshi is not keen to get even moksha, because he has got the bhakti, and who has achieved bhakti, he will not like to get moksha, saiji moksha. So moksha api uto, the salvation is not his desire also. Then what saying of the material things? Bhaktim param bhagavati labdhavan purushobhyai, because he has achieved the bhakti in purushobhyai, in Shri Bhagavan. Should I give gap or continuously? So bhaktim param bhagavati labdhavan purushottame, because Shri Markandeya Muni has achieved the bhakti in purushottam. And that bhakti is parabhakti. Parabhakti means shuddha bhakti. These are the synonyms. Shuddha, para, eka, uttama. These are having the same meaning. Anya vilashita shunyam, gyan karmadhyan avritam, ankulyan krishnan shunyanam bhakti uttama. It is uttama, para, eka, nirguna. These are having the same meaning. So parabhakti, that means अन्य आप नाश्ता शून्यम ही डज नॉट रिक्वायर एनीथिंग रेस्ट देन भक्ति द गोल ऑफ भक्ति इज भक्ति इफ द गोल ऑफ भक्ति इज एनी अदर थिंग देन इट इज गौणी भक्ति एंड इफ द गोल ऑफ भक्ति इज गोल भक्ति दैट इज द उत्तम भक्ति By bhakti, if a person is wanting, is desiring the material happiness, that is, then bhakti will be gone, gone. That means he will be subordinate. And by giving moksha or bhog, bhakti will vanish. Bhakti will go away. But if a person is desiring Shri Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Seva, then the bhakti, the goal of bhakti is, aim of bhakti is bhakti, and that will be called Uttama, Eka, Nirguna, and so on. So, para. So, Bhaktim Param Bhagavati, he has got the Nirguna Bhakti in Shri Bhagavan, Labdhaman Purushobhyaya. Shri Krishna is all pervading Purush. Pur means the city and Sha means who lies. That means who is pervading in everywhere, everything. He is called Purush. This body is a city and is a Pur and the Jivatma and Paramatma is lying in it. So he is called Purusha. So Pure Shayati iti Purusha, who is lying in the, who is resting in that. That means in heart Paramatma is resting. In heart Jivatma is resting. So Jivatma and Paramatma is called Purusha. So Purushobhyaya. And that Purusha is also Jivatma as well as Paramatma, both Purush. Both are called Purush. The main Purush is Paramatma. The assistant Purush is Jivatma. And both are Abhyay. Both are immortal. And they will not dissolve ever. They will not die ever. Abhyay. Athapi Samvidishyamaha Bhavani Eten Sadhana. Even then, I have got this opportunity to talk with, have a dialogue with Markandeya Muni. Markandeya Muni is a great sadhu, and if I will meet him, then some subject about Shri, some glories of Shri Krishna will be manifested in our dialogue. So I will also go and have a talk with Shri Markandeya. So it is an opportunity and let me utilize it. So in this way, Shri Markandeya Muni, Shri Shivji went to Shri Markandeya. So I am Himmatu Labha. Miram Sadhu Samagama. The Sadhu Samagam, the company with Sadhu, this is also a great benefit. So let me utilize it. Let me feel it. Because sadhu-sang, sarva-shastra bhavai. Every shastra saying sadhu-sang, sadhu-sang is the best thing. And Krishna bhakti janma mula hai sadhu-sang. Bhakti janye teho kuna hai moksham. Everybody says that bhakti will born by sadhu-sang. But while the bhakti is born, bhakti is achieved, then sadhusang became the moksha, relishment of bhakti. So sadhusang is not the meeting of sadhu. Sadhu is not a sadhan, but it is the result. It is not the method, medium, but it is the result. So that is not only a medium, but it is also a result. So, Krishna Bhakti Janma Mool, the cause of the birth of Bhakti is Hai Sadhu Sangha. Sadhu Sangha is considered to be the original or to the resource of Bhagavad Bhakti. But Bhakti Chandi, while the Bhakti is manifested and Bhakti is born, then Seho Puno Hoy Mukshan, the sadhusang becomes the mukshan. And Shri Rudra Bhagavan is he's the best Bhakti. Vaishnavanam Yathasav Shambhu, Shri Rudra Bhagavan is the best Vaishnav. So he is always very much keen for satsang. And Shri Rudra Bhagavan always glorifies the meeting of Sant. Mainly, Shiv is very much fond of satsang. And in Rudra Geet to Pracheta, Shri Markandeya, Shri Rudra Bhagavan has also said that Kshandhe Nath Tule Naswargam Nath Narbhavam. O Pracheta, I am not comparing the Swarg with satsang. Neither I am comparing the Swarg with Puna Apanarbhav, the salvation, moksha. The Swarg is considered to be the last stage of karma, and moksha is considered to be the last achievement of jnana. But which are the last last destination of karma yoga and jnana yoga? And bhakti and satsang is the second step of bhakti, adav shraddha tatha satsanga. So here the second stage is, if it is considered compared with the last destination of jnana or karma, even then Shri Rudra Bhagavan says that I will say no. There the negative expression will he will express. So kshadhe nap tole, I am not comparing the moksha with the first stage of bhakti. So satsang is so great thing. So here Shri Shiv Rudra Bhagavan is also saying ki I am the parmo labha naam sadhu samagamaha, that a person will get sadhu samagam. So that will be a very jubilant thing, that will be a very happiness giving things. Think sutvacha ityukta tam upayayo bhagavan satvatam gati. In this way Shri Shiva reached to Shri Markandeya. Tam upayayo, he reached to Markandeya. Bhagavan satvatam gati, Shri Markandeya Muni is Shri Shiva is satvatam gati. He is the destination of all bhaktagan. Everyone bhakta is going his head and trying to get Shri Shiva his boat. Because without the help of Shri Shiva, one cannot get bhakti, because he is the best bhakti. So Bhagavan Satvatam Gati, he is the destination of all Satva, all Vaishnava. Sat means Vishnu, and Vata means who worship Vishnu. Satva, Sat means Vishnu. Sat, this is the name of Vishnu. And Pat means Vishnu is the deity of those persons. That is called Satva. So Sat Vatam. Ishana Sarva Vidyanam. Shri Markandeya Muni, Hare Krishna, Shri Shivji, Shri Rudra Bhagavan, he is the master of all Vidya. Because every Vidya and every language is coming from the drum of from the Damru of Shri Shiva. So, Shiva is considered the master and Shiva is considered the main resource of all Vidya. So, Ishanas Sarva Vidya Nam, he is the master of all Vidya. Ishwara Sarva Dehina, and he is the Ishwara of all Deh. So, Ishwara Sarva Dehina, because Ahankar and Shiv is the master, Rudra is the master of Ahankar. And our all things are resting in Ahankar. Whole Sukshma Shari, whole subtle body is always resting in Ahankar. So Ahankar is considered to be the 12th thing. The Ekadash Indri always rests in the 12th thing. Ahankar is Shaya. Ahankar is the bed where the 11 things, 11 with man and all 10 senses are resting. So Ishana Sarvidyana, Shiva was the master of all Vidya, and Ishwara Sarvidyana, and he is the master of all Dehadhari, all persons. Tayo Agamanam Sakshat, Isho Jagatmano, Naved Ruddhi Vrittihi, Atmanam Vishwameva Cha. Tayo Agamanam Sakshat. So Shiva reached there, but Markandeya Muni was in trance position, in samadhi. And being in trance position, he is not noticing the arrival of Sri Shiva. So he was not even seeing that who came and who is Shiva. So he was not recognizing this. He is not noticing. So Tayo Agamanam Sakshat. Ishayo Jagatmano, Sakshat Isho, Parvati and Shri Shiva is Sakshat Ishwar. And even they have come Jagatmanaha, everything is in Shiva. Even then, Tayo Abhinam, Shri Markandeya Muni was not noticing his arrival. Naved Ruddhi, because he has controlled and stopped his intellect for the outer things. And he became very much inward. And he was meditating Shri Krishna in his heart. So, naved ruddhadihi vrittihi, atmanam vishwameva cha. Even then, he was not noticing his own body. Markandeya Muni was not noticing his own body. So Atmanam, that means his own body, he was not noting, and Vishwamevacha, in the same way, he was not noticing the whole universe. So neither universe, neither his own body, and neither the arrival of Bhagavan Shiva. This anything was not noticed by Shri Markandeya Muni, because he was in the transposition and his was in the all this seeing one thing, Shri Krishna. So, Bhagavan Tadvidhyaya Girisho Yoga Maya Avishat Tadvahakasham Vaishchitam Viveshwara. Shri Shiva immediately recognized this, that he is in the Nirvikalpa Samadhi Sthiti, and he is not knowing him himself even. The Tan Matraika Bhanta, that is Samadhi, where the desired and meditated thing is only existing and other things are not existing, neither knowledge, neither knower, and neither the other anything. So, Gyata Ge Gyan, this is the three phases, and only one phase is rest at that Vimkalp Samadhi, that is Ge. So he is only seeing Shri Krishna. Neither he is noticing himself and neither he is noticing that I am seeing Shri Krishna by my knowledge. So the instrument, knowledge is also there. Was not there. His knowledge was also merged into the Shri Krishna. Only Krishna was in his transposition. So neither the knower, neither the knowledge, only the object, Shri Krishna, he was in his mind. Bhagavan tada avigyaya, Krishna yogmaya. Bhagavan Shri Shiva, he is full of yogmaya, his self-opulences, and he immediately understood that he is in the transposition. And he thinks that I may remain stood here, remain stood here for thousand years. Even then this trance will not over, this transposition. And Markandeya Muni will always remain in transposition. So, and I reached here for satsang. So that means this desire cannot be fulfilled if I remain here for 1,000 years also. Then Shri Krishna is very much kindful. And he thought Shiva does not have such potentiality that removing me, Shiva can appear in his transposition, in his meditation. Because Krishna is avatari, Shiva is a avatar. Krishna is Anshi, he is the soul, and Shri Shiva is a part. So the part cannot remove the soul. Due to that, Shri Krishna himself became very much kind, and Krishna has just minimized his opulences and allowed Shri Shiva to appear in the transposition. Then, where Shri Markandeya Muni was meditating the Pitambara of Shri Krishna, there he saw that it is Padambara, the skin of a lion. Where he is meditating the Banmala of five colors, then he sees that a serpent or a dragon is in the neck. Where he is meditating the tilak of Shri Krishna Chandra, there he sees the third eyes. Where he is seeing meditating the kirit mukut or the peak of feather, Mayur Mukut. There he is seeing the jata, and where he is seeing the very beautiful bunch of flowers, there he is seeing that it is the flow of Ganges, Ganga. So everything is changed. So he was thinking that I was meditating and I was realizing, witnessing the beauty of Shri Krishna and how this is the other form. And immediately, being very much perturbed, Markandeya Muni opened his eyes and he saw that Shri Shiva is there. So, Bhagavan Tadubhyak Yoga, Avishat Tadguhakasha, Bhagavan Shiva has entered. It shows Shri Vishnu Chakravarti is saying in his commentary that Shiva cannot remove Shri Krishna, but it is Shri Krishna. He is Shri Krishna who allowed Shiv to came in the transposition of Shri Markandeya. And in the place of Shri Krishna, he sees Shri Markandeya, Shiv. Akasham Bhayushchitra Bhaveshwaraha. Shri Shiv entered in the heart of Shri Markandeya Muni as the air can enter in this body also. In our body, air is also, by breathing, air is also coming down. Atmanyapishvam praptam tadit pinda chatadharam. In mind, in his heart, Markandeya Muni seeing that Shiv has achieved here tadit pinda chatadharam. He is bearing the yellowish jata, the bunch of hairs. Tadit pinda chatadharam. What is jata? So, tadit pinda chatadharam. Draksha. Shiva is having three eyes. Draksha. Three eyes. Dashbhujam. And having 10 arms. Rudra is with 10 arms. Pranchu, he was tall. Udyantamyo Bhaskaram, as if the sun is rising. Udyantamyo Bhaskaram. Vyagra Charmambar Dharam, he was wearing the skin of a lion. Shul Dhanu, Ari Asi Charmugi. And Shul, Trishul, the three-pointed Trishul, he was having, and the bow, Dhanush, and the sword, and Chan, the shield, and in this way, and Chakra, the wheel, he was having all weapons within Akshamala, Damaru, and having the japmala and damru, the drum, and kapal and parush, sometimes a axe and kapal, the skull of the men. So he was having all these things. Vibran sahasa bhatam vichakshinata vishmita. Seeing in these things, he Markandeya became very much extinguished, vismit, kimidam kutu evethi. How it is appearing the other thing than my meditation. Samadhi virtu muni, and that muni in this way came out of his transposition. Then they opened the dandishe, and opening his eyes, he saw sagaram sumyagatam. With Parvati, Shri Shiva has reached there. Rudram Tarokai Guru. Shri Rudra is the Guru of Tarokai. He is the spiritual master of all Tarokai. Rudram Tarokai Guru. Nanam Sri. And seeing Shiva, Shri Markandeya Muni put his head and saluted him. Tasmai Sapanyam Gandha. Sagaraya Samobaya, Samobaya. Markandeya Muni immediately offered the all offerings to Shri Shiva with Parvati and with his all antaras also. He is offering various offerings. Swagat Asan, welcome, Shiva, Padya, Arga, Gandha, Dhoop, Dhoop, Deep, everything. So, seed and the water for washing his feet, and argha, the water to wash his hand, that is Arha. Then Kandha, the pointing of the sandal, Dhoop and Deep. He, the lamp and Dhoop, is the offering that. Aha Chatman Bhaveno Pun Kamasite Prabhu Karvam. And he, joining his hand, was praying that Atman Bhaveno Pun Kamaha. Oh Shiv, you are self sufficient in yourself. You are Pun Kam, you have achieved the whole desires. You have fulfilled, you have the all desires fulfilled in you. Atman Bhaveno, it is your own opulences. That by your own opulences, you are getting Pun Kam. You are getting the full Kam. Karvam Kimishanam. O Isham, what should I do? Jeladam Dhrutam Jagat. Because you are all pervading in whole Jagat. Jeladam Dhrutam. And by your kind, whole Jagat is being very much happy, full of joy, joyful. Nirvatam is fulfilled and happy. Whole Jagat is very happy. Namah Shivaya Shantaya. I am saluting to Shri Shiv Shantaya. You are very much transcript. And Satvaya Pramadaya Cha. You are full of knowledge and Pramadaya. That means you are the place of all happiness and all jubilance. So, Pramad means Anand, Sukh, whole happiness that is resting in you. Rajo Jushe, Api Aghoraya. Though you are using Rajo Gun even then, you are not pressed by Rajo Gun. Sometimes you show that you are angry. You are getting angry, but actually saying you are free from all Rajo. So Rajo Jushe, Api Aghoraya. Though you are very much sattva, full of happiness, even then you seem to be full of illusion as well as full of ignorance. So sattva is happiness, rajoguna is illusion and tamoguna is ignorance. So rajojushe api aghoraya. So you are using rajoguna, the illusion, even then aghoraya. You are seems to be very much cruel, but you are not cruel. You are aghor, you are very much kindful. Actually say you are full of kindness. So your appearance is seen that it is rudra, but it is not dangerous. It is very peaceful and very much joy-giving. Evam tasya bhagavan atmeva satam gati. In this way, Markandeya Muni worshipped Shri Krishna atmeva satam gati. Paritrishtam pasannatma. Markandeya Muni became, Bhagavan Shiva became very much happy, paritrishta, satisfied by his prayer. And pasannatma, being very much happy, prasastam bhashatam. Markandeya Muni started to say and started to express his happiness to Markandeya Muni. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Balam Brishna Kamam Bardesha Vayam Kraya. Oh, Markandeya Muni, you can ask any benediction, whatever you want, because Vardesha Vayam Kraya. I, Brahma and Vishnu, we three deities are Vardesha. We are very much competent to give the Vartanti, Vardesha. So Vardesha went through. We both are Vardan giving. Amogham, Darshanam Yesham. And while I feel appear to you, our appearance to a person is amog. It is not in vain ever. It is always fruitful. It will not be fruitless, fruited. So our appearance is very much fruited. So whatever you want, you can ask from me. So darshanam yesham, martyo yad bindate mrtam. A person will get amrutam, will get amrut from me. Martyo yad bindate amrutam. In this way, a martyr, a person will get the immortality from me. Brahma sattva shanta nisanga bhuta vatsala ekanta bhakta asmasu nidvaita samdarshana. Brahma sattva shanta. Mainly, I love two Brahma. Because they are studious in Veda. So Brahma. Brahma means Veda. And Brahma means who knows Veda is called Brahma. Sadhava. They are very saint persons. Good persons. Shanta, tranquil. And Nisanga, they do not have any involvement or attachment to the useless things, worthless things. They are always keen and they are always involved in the fruitful things. That is Shri Krishna. So Brahmana, Sadhva, Shanta, Nisanga, and Bhutvasala. And the Brahmana are mainly Bhutvasala. That means they are loving to every person. So he is giving the features of Brahman. Normally Brahman, normally and naturally Brahman have, most of Brahman have these qualities by Bhatta. So Brahmana sadhu shanta, Brahman became sadhu. Exception is the all. But normally Brahmana sadhu, shanta, nisanga and bhutvasala. They are loving to every person. Ekanta bhakta asmasu. And they are also God fearing and God loving. Ekanta bhakta asmasu. Nirvaina samdarshana. And normally they do not have, if they have any enmity, then they leave it very earlier. For sometimes they remain angry and after that they leave it. So, nirvaina samdarshana. They are having the equal eyes to everyone and they are not having the partiality with other persons. They are normally they are impartial. So samadarshana, they became impartial. One should recognize the Brahman should recognize this God. Okay, Brahmana sadhava, shanta, nisanga, bhutvatsala, ekant bhakta asmasu, nirvaina samdarshana. These are the natural phenomena of a Brahman. These are the qualities of a Brahman and they should be adopted. And try to adopt them. Saloka lokpala stan, vadanti archanti upasate. So, everyone is worshipping Shri Brahma. Everybody is respecting Brahma. Saloka Lokpala, with whole Lok and whole masters of Lokpala. They are also worshipping Brahma. Tan padanti archanti upasate. They are always talking and servicing, and they are worshipping Brahma. Aham cha Bhagavan Brahma, Swayam cha Hari Ishwara. Even I, Shri Brahma, as well as Shri Vishnu, is also worshipping Shri Brahma, all Brahma. So they are also respecting the Brahma. Nate mayachute. And this worshipping is to teach other persons. Actually, Brahman is not so great. That is, he can take the worship of Shri Krishna or Shri Narayan. But Narayan says to Shri Sankadev that by the glories of you, Brahman, I am being glorified. So, in this way, so that is only to teach the other persons, that all persons should respect Brahman, but it does not mean that Brahman becomes so great. Brahman is a normal person, a normal jeev. So, nate mayachute jecho vidam api chakshate. A right person will not have the duality and the difference between Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. So na, my means I, Rudra. Achyute, that means Shiva Vishnu. And Ajay means Brahma. They will not have that difference. And they will serve the whole things, all three entities equally. And they will not consider the difference between them. Atmanishtajanasyapi tad yuman vayam imahi natmanishtajanasyapi. Shri, I have this idea that everywhere there is Shri Krishna, everywhere is Paramatma. So, natmanishtajanasyapi, I do not think, Shivji is saying that I do not think that I am separate and the other person is separate, because the Atma is one and at last everyone is a part of Shri Krishna. So everyone is respectable. So it cannot be said that a person is respectable and another person is a part of humiliation. That should not be considered in this thing. And a very beautiful statement is here. Naiham mayan tirthani na deva chetano jeta te punantyur kadino yuyam darshan matrata. He is glorifying the satsang, sant. Shri Shivji is glorifying sant. And he is saying that naiham mayan tirthani. Actually, the Tirth is considered where the water is there, or the pious or holy river is there. That is called Tirth. But he is saying, Shivji is saying, that only a pure and pious water is not Tirth. Nayamyana Tirthani. Tirth should not be considered only a holy water. Na deva chetno jita. And the deities that is worshipped on the altar, that is never a stone. Na deva chetno jita. Without life, it is only a stone. It should not be considered ever. Neither it should be considered that it is only a normal water. In the same way, neither the deity should be considered that it is only a stone or only a metal. Nadeva chetno jita. So naihamyat. That means the tirth should be considered as direct Shri Krishna or direct Shri Narayan. Is tirth. He has taken the form of the water. It should be considered. And in the same way, the deity, idol, that is worshipped on the altar, that should be considered that Shri Krishna has incarnated in the form of a Shri Vigraha, Archa, Archa Vigraha. So Archa is Shri Krishna himself. In the same way, the water flow, that is Shri Krishna himself. Te punanti ur kalina. But these tirth and these devta, they punanti ur kalina. They purifies, they purify a man after a long time. And they will take much more time. But yuyam darshan matrata, you are so that by only seeing you, thus you means santagan. Santagan are so great that by darshan, by appearance, they purify a person. So if a person will go to tirth, holy place, and there he will dip, and there he will follow the rules of the tirth, then tirth will purify him. In the same way, if a person go to a temple and having the emotion of respect and thinking that the deity is not a stone, it is Shri Krishna himself, and he is offering the various worships to Shri Krishna or that deity, then that deity will effect and he will be kindful. But in the comparison of the tirth and in the comparison of the idol, sant are much more effective and gloryful, because by seeing them everything is can be achieved. So, and they makes one's heart very much clear, clean by only his appearance. So this is a good statement in the glory of the sun, satsang. So te puranti, the immediate and quick effect is found by satsang rather than the worshipping of the deity, or rather than going to the tirthya. So satsang is the main thing. Brahmane bhyo namah, namasyama. So Shri Shiva is saying that I am praying Brahma. Yesmat rupam trayimayam vibhrati. Because in Brahma, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, all are resting in Brahma. Atma samadhan tapasadhyaya sayami. And Brahma has naturally, atma samadhan means meditating attitude. Brahma has tap, he is full of austerity, and swadhyaya, the studiousness, studies, and sanyam, and the renouncement and the controlling. The Brahma has these qualities, so I am just praying all Brahma. Shravana darshana dapi mahapatma vah shudheran atyaya terishyapi kim samashradhi. If a person is witnessing Shri Brahman or listening the glories of Brahman or having the talk, and his language is, his voice is heard by his ears, so Shravana Darshana Dapi Mahapatma Kupan. Even a person is very much Patki, he is very much wicked person, even then he will be Shuddhiran, he will be purified immediately. Kim sambhashanadihi. So what saying of talking? In this way, Bhagavan Shiva prayed Brahman And Sri Sutji is saying that Markandeya was listening the very greatness, great words of Bhagavan Shiva, very udar and liberal language of Bhagavan Shiva, and he was became very, very much affected, and he prayed in the lotus feet of Shiva, and then Shiva is giving him birth. So he will give two birth, that you live long. And the other is only living long is not a thing. That will not work. The main thing is you live long as well as you became the orator of a Puran. And if you will be a preacher and will live long, then it will be naturally possible that you will be benefiting so many persons. So you live long and you became the preacher. So these two, Puranacharya taste, you became the Puranacharya as well as you live long. So two, and it is a very good benediction. Because a intelligent and a sadhak will live, Sri Gurudev will live with us for a long time, then we will be benefited very much with his kindness. So Shiva is giving this benefit. Vrindavan Harilal ki jai, Govind jai jai Gopal jai jai, Govind jai jai Gopal.